How to test water quality at home without a kit. There are several types of water quality tests that can be done without a test kit. Here are some examples. Sight and smell test. This involves observing the water for any discoloration, cloudiness, or unusual odor. The sight and smell test is a simple and quick way to detect certain types of water quality problems. Here's how to do a sight and smell test. Collect a sample of the water in a clean, odor-free container. Take a close look at the water sample. If the water appears cloudy, discolored, or has visible particles, it may be contaminated with sediment or other particles. If the water appears clear, it may be free from visible contaminants. Take a sniff of the water sample. If the water has a musty or earthy smell, it may be contaminated with bacteria or algae. If the water smells like rotten eggs or sulfur, it may contain hydrogen sulfide gas. If the water smells like bleach or chlorine, it may be overtreated with disinfectants. If the water has a metallic or chemical odor, it may contain industrial chemicals or pollutants. Compare the appearance and smell of the water to the appearance and smell of clean water from a different source, such as bottled water or tap water from a different location. If the water appears significantly different from clean water or has an unusual odor, it may be a sign of a water quality problem. Turbidity test. This involves filling a clear glass with water and observing the water for any visible particles or cloudiness. You can perform a turbidity test at home without a test kit using the following steps. Fill a clear glass with water from the source you want to test. Hold the glass up to a light source, such as a lamp or window, and observe the water for any visible particles. Cloudiness or discoloration. Compare the appearance of the water to that of clean tap water or bottled water from a different source. You can also perform a rough estimate of the turbidity by looking at the water and estimating how far down you can see into the glass. Generally, the greater the distance, the lower the turbidity. pH test. This can be done using a piece of litmus paper, which changes color based on the acidity or alkalinity of the water. You can perform a simple pH test at home without a test kit using the following steps. Collect a sample of water that you want to test in a clean and clear glass. Cut a piece of red cabbage into small pieces and add it to the water. Allow the water and cabbage mixture to sit for about 30 minutes, stirring occasionally. After 30 minutes, strain out the cabbage and observe the color of the water. Compare the color of the water to a pH color chart, which you can easily find online, to determine the approximate pH level of the water. For example, if the water turns pink or red, it is likely to have a low pH level, while if the water turns blue or green, it may have a high pH level. It's important to note that this method is not as accurate as using a proper pH test kit or laboratory analysis, but it can give you an indication of the approximate pH level of the water. If you need a more accurate measurement or suspect that your water may have significant pH issues, it is recommended to have it tested by a certified laboratory. Bleach test. This involves adding a small amount of household bleach to a water sample and observing for any color changes or cloudiness. A bleach test is a simple and quick way to check if your water contains any harmful bacteria or pathogens. To perform a bleach test, follow these steps. Fill a clean and clear glass with water that you want to test. Add a few drops of regular unscented bleach to the water. The general guideline is to use 8 drops of bleach per gallon of water. But you can adjust the amount based on the amount of water you are testing. Stir the water and bleach mixture and let it sit for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, observe the color of the water. If the water is still clear, it is likely to be safe to drink. If the water has turned cloudy or has sediment at the bottom of the glass, it may contain harmful bacteria or pathogens and should not be consumed. It's important to note that a bleach test is not a substitute for laboratory testing and cannot detect chemical contaminants in the water. If you suspect that your water may contain chemical contaminants, it is recommended to have it tested by a certified laboratory. Sedimentation test. This involves allowing a water sample to sit undisturbed in a clear container for at least an hour and observing for any sediment or particles that settle to the bottom. A sedimentation test is a simple way to check for visible particles and sediments in water. To perform a sedimentation test, follow these steps. Fill a clear and clean glass with the water that you want to test. Allow the glass to sit undisturbed for a few hours or overnight. After the water has settled, observe the bottom of the glass for any visible particles or sediments. If the water is clear and there are no visible particles, it is likely safe to drink. However, if there are visible particles or sediments, it may indicate contamination and the water should not be consumed.